Thank you. Well, dang. That didn't go as planned. But when does it? We're in uncharted territory. Obviously, if I would have asked Bill Mitchell, hey, what lifter should I be putting in this thing? He probably would have told me what to get. Unfortunately, I didn't ask that question. I assumed, and it bit me in the butt. It's nobody's fault but mine. These are custom applications. This is not a kit. This is not send me everything to put my engine together like a model. It ain't that. It's scour the entire world looking for every piece that goes together. So in this case, we need a different lifter. I got on the phone immediately. I talked to Pete Harris at Crower. He is the lifter guy. Mr. Pete Harris knows his business. I told him what happened, where, as you guys just saw, the tie bar was contacting the lifter boss. And he said, oh, you need such and such lifter body, blah, blah, blah. He knew exactly what it was. Unfortunately, they're on back order. They're in production right now. They're going to be 5 weeks until they're done. So what I need to do is two things. I need to try and find a lifter in the meantime, just to see if there's one out there that I can order and get here sooner. If that's available, I will do that. It's got to be very specific in its height, diameter, and oiling hole location. The oil hole must be opposite of the feed hole that's in the lifter bore. And these engines, the feed hole comes in on the cylinder side of the block. It's a tiny little hole that feeds that bushed lifter bore. The oil then has to go around the lifter to get to the opposite side to then fill the lifter and go up through the pushrod. Very critical. If the oil hole in the lifter bore is lined up with the oil hole in the lifter, then you have problems with over oiling and in a bushed block scoring or getting the other side of the lifter hot, and we don't want to have any problems down the road. So we're trying to make sure that we think this stuff through. You know, I'm no engine builder. I'm just doing this. I'm winging it. I've built engines in the past, but I've never built anything at this level, so it's all new to me. I have confidence in this process. I feel like I have thought as many things through as possible, and I'm willing to take some hits when I come up short. This is one of the times I kind of came up short.